The next problem is Norton's theorem. Obtain Norton's equivalent circuit across PQ. Okay, so it is the circuit. See here, there is a current source. So here the current source is parallel with the resistor and the voltage source is series with the resistor. Okay, so here also an voltage source series with the resistor. So in the mari problem mandale, you can choose the source transformation. Okay, so what is the step one? What is the first step? You want to draw the equivalent circuit. Okay, so what is equivalent circuit? That is the current, so short circuit current, Norton's current is parallel to the Norton's resistor. Okay, Rn. So now first step, you want to find the short circuit current. In order to find the short circuit current, you want to short circuit the load resistor. But here, see, here they have asked to find PQ. You want to find Norton's equivalent circuit across PQ. So here there are two resistors. So you can use the source transformation method, then it is easy for you. Okay, so here see the diagram. One resistor is parallel with the current source. Because the current source is resistor parallel. So using source transformation, you can convert this. That is V is equal to I into R. 4 2s are 8. Okay, and it is series with the resistor. So now the circuit is in the form. If a circuit in a formula marita. 8 volt, next 4 ohm, okay, then this circuit, okay, so sorry, here I forgot to draw this, okay, so here 5 volt and 2 ohm resistor. So now, see, it is the simplified diagram. So listen, here 2 voltage sources are series. If 2 voltage sources are series, you can add this. So it become 10 volt and these two resistors are series. So you can add this resistor, so it become 8 ohm. Okay, so now you want to find the short circuit current. So it is along here, short circuit current. So now see, listen, here there is one current source. So now the voltage source is series with the resistor. The FD mathiklam current source parallel with the resistor. Here also voltage source series with the resistor. You can convert this to current source parallel with the resistor. Then what happened here? I is equal to V by R, that is 10 by 8. Okay, I is equal to V by R, 10 by 8. 10 by 8 is 1.25. Okay, and this is 8 ohm. Next here, I is equal to V by R, that is 5 by 2, that is 2.5. Parallel with the resistor, 2 ohm. Okay, so now see, all these resistors or all these current sources are parallel, so you can add this. But see the direction, 5 plus 1.5, 6.25. And it is opposite direction. So minus 2.5, that is 6.25 minus 2.5, the answer is 3.75. Okay, here the direction is this direction. Maximum direction choose panikonga, that is this direction. Okay, 6.25 minus 2.5. What is 3.75? Okay, and the resistor, these two resistors are parallel. So 8 into 2 divided by 8 plus 2, that is 1.6 ohm. And here this is the short circuit current. So now this current is short circuit current. The current then a flow of the circuit. So the short circuit current value is 3.75. Can you understand? Okay, it is 3.75. So the parallel resistance is valuable. So 3.75. Next, you want to find R Thevenin. In order to find R Thevenin, you want to open circuit the current source, short circuit the voltage source. Okay, open circuit the current source. So, 4 ohm are series and 2 ohm is parallel. So 8 ohm is parallel to 2 ohm. So you got 8 into 2 divided by 8 plus 2. So what is the value? 1.6 ohm. Okay, so the Norton's resistor value is 1.6 ohm. So now you can draw the equivalent circuit. That is, current source is 3.75 and the Norton's resistor value is 1.6 ohm. Okay.